Wednesday here at 6 o'clock. We've been having a lot of fun this Wednesday morning, don't you think?
Yeah, of course.
Chris isn't here.
T-Wolves kicking
off. T-Wolves, we sent him to Target Center because it's going to be a lot of fun tonight. They're taking on Oklahoma City Thunder for their opener.
Or tipping off, that is. What's going on, Chris?
Hey, you know, I've been showing off some of my basketball moves, and they haven't been very impressive, so I'm going to get rid of this and take it more from a fan's point of view. If you're in the stands tonight, you're going to get one of these glow sticks. Isn't this awesome? A great way to kick off the season. Tip off just after 7 o'clock against the Oklahoma City Thunder. It's going to be a great season. The anticipation is huge. You got Rudy Gobert coming to town. Try saying that three times. Karl-Anthony Towns, of course, perennial all-star, and you got the Ant-Man, Anthony Edwards. What did those three equal? Playoffs, if you ask me, and it all begins tonight. A little later on, we're going to talk about the season with the COO, and we're going to also get to a bunch of great merch you can buy this year to help support the team. Merch like this. Isn't this sweet, guys? Look at this.
I like that sweatshirt. It fits you nice, too. Good stuff. Good stuff. Good swag there, Chris. We'll check back soon. Hopefully they pack the house there tonight, too.
Right, yeah, and a sweatshirt will for sure keep you warm. Maybe throw a little vest on over top. Your hour-by-hour planner will show temps starting off in the mid-20s again this morning. So by late morning hours, you'll see temps start climbing to the upper 30s, mid-40s here by 3 o'clock this afternoon with some passing clouds. So we will have to talk about some cloud cover. Just a brief period of clouds today. We'll still see the sun. Here are your statewide highs. I'm also going to be talking about those current wind chills we're waking up to. Also, a big warm-up on the way, so stick around for that. Alicia?
And if you're waking up in Minnesota, it's the last day to send the kids off to the bus stop as MEA weekend will be kicking off, and it's pretty quiet out there for the school buses or if you have school drop-off this morning. No crashes to slow you down, and drive times are average metro-wide. Breaking news overnight in the North Metro. Investigators are trying to figure out what caused a piece of Maple Grove history to go up in flames. It happened at the Maple Grove Village Hall late last night. And this is video from right after crews got the fire out. The building served as a primary office in the city from the 30s until the 1970s. And most recently, it was used as a rec center.
Initially came in as heavy smoke in the area. We upgraded it to a structure fire and took it to a first alarm. Just to have enough crews to work through, we elevated to a second alarm. So for us, with a second alarm, it brings four of our five stations to the scene, and then our fifth one provides coverage for the city.
The fire chief tells us that they're still looking for whatever sparked these flames. And be sure to stay with Care 11 for the latest on this story. We'll track updates on care11.com. And of course, if we learn anything new, you'll be the first to know. We're less than 3 weeks out from Election Day, and for the first and only time this election cycle, the candidates for governor squared off on live TV. Governor Tim Walz and challenger Dr. Scott Jensen debated live at KTTC, which is down in Rochester. And Cece's breaking down some of the biggest moments, and she's live from the Capitol right now. Hey, Cece.
Good morning, Alicia. Yeah, Walz and Jensen already met on stage once this year already. And as you mentioned, yesterday was the second time down at KTTC TV. And they were there for an hour, both candidates touching on issues such as healthcare, the economy, education, also crime. Now, when the topic of abortion came up, Jensen said he, quote, won't ban abortion because he can't. And this is true. The governor can't reverse the Minnesota Supreme Court's Doe versus Gomez decision single-handedly that protects abortion rights in the state. And when he said that, Walz accused Jensen of changing his tune, since Jensen said he was going to ban abortions when he was running for the GOP nomination. The two also went head-to-head about the state's response to the murder of George Floyd.
I'm proud of Minnesota's first responders who were out there, from firefighters to police to the National Guard to citizens that were out there.
You heard it here. Governor Walz just told you, I am proud of Minnesota's response, referring to the riots in May and June of 2020.
The third and final debate between the two is set for next Friday. Now, coming up in about 30 minutes, Alicia, we have some post-debate commentary from the two. We hear what they have to say about the other. Back to you.
Cece Gaines reporting live from the Capitol for us this morning. Thank you. Well, this weekend, Vice President Kamala Harris will be in the Twin Cities supporting Governor Tim Walz. She's making stops at several events in Minneapolis and St. Paul. And of course, remember, everything you need to know about Election Day in Minnesota is just one text away. You can send the word vote to 763-797-7215. And we'll text you back with our most comprehensive voters toolkits. Remember, that's a text-only number. Well, tonight's one of the busiest travel weekends in Minnesota is kicking off. MEA weekend kicks off once kids get off the bus later today. And you can expect the airport and the roads are both going to be really busy. Now, airport leaders tell us almost 37,000 people are expected to pass through TSA starting tomorrow. MSP says extra staff has been added. However, you want to prepare yourself for the heavy traffic. Well, tonight, heartbroken family and friends will gather to remember Gabriel Mendoza. His family tells us he was killed in a crossfire of a shootout in Uptown while he was working security at Firehouse Bar. Right now, MPD investigators are releasing very few details about what exactly happened. This morning, Mendoza's mother says she's feeling angry.
I want to tell you guys that we need to find who did this, and I'm really hoping that community will step up and help us figure out who did this, but it doesn't matter if you don't, because I am here to tell you you're here messing with the wrong people.
Right now, there is a GoFundMe to help this family out. We do have a link posted right now at care11.com. This morning, the FBI is looking for your help. They are renewing their push to find Umbrella Man. Yeah, the FBI released these pictures of this suspect. They say the man carried an umbrella, wore a black baseball hat with a unique logo and the letters LMCO during the unrest following George Floyd's murder. Investigators say he was seen breaking windows at AutoZone Parts on Lake Street and vandalizing the Minneapolis Police Department's 3rd Precinct. Anyone with any details or info on him should call 1-800-CALL-FBI. Another staple in downtown Minneapolis is closing, leaving a space in the theater district. Rock Bottom Brewery on Hennepin is now closed. The company's website said the closure is because of circumstance beyond their control. The Star Trib says it was the state's very first brew pub. Well, they were less than 100 days until the 137th St. Paul Winter Carnival, which is dubbed as the coolest celebration on Earth. One of the coldest, I should say, too. Coming back this year is the Torchlight Parade and ice carvings at Rice Park. They're also going to have some new events like Light Up the Park and Lip Sync Battles. The festivities start January 26. Should be a fun time. All right, well, hey, it's nearly go time for our Timberwolves, ready to kick off, tip off, their season against the Oklahoma City Thunder. Should be a good matchup.
Yeah, for sure. There's a lot of excitement surrounding the team, and this will be pretty cool. Chris.
He's at Target Center this morning. We gave him a fun task to do a little basketball this morning. Tell us what's up this year.
Oh, yeah, we've been having a great time down here. I've been shooting some hoops. But, yeah, Alicia, it's tip-off for basketball, kick-off for football, but we'll forgive you on that one. I have the Timberwolves Glow Rally Stick here. This is what everyone in attendance is going to get tonight. We're here with Ryan, the Chief Operating Officer, and there's a lot of excitement going into this season. Big offseason acquisition, Rudy Gobert. Tell us about how he's going to fit in the team and what's expected of the team this year.
Yeah, thanks, and it's so great to be here, the kind of the calm before the storm here. 17,000 fans waving those light-up wands tonight. We're excited. This season is a continuation of last year. It was really magical the way the city and the team rallied together and just the way everything sort of built as the season went on. And then as we went into the off season with a ton of excitement, we put a lot of gas on the fire, so to speak, with that acquisition of Rudy Gobert. And season ticket sales and just general interest is at really high levels right now heading into the season.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think I've seen interest like this since way back when Kevin Garnett was on the team. I mean, that's going back like 14, 15 years. So it is exciting to have, you know, basketball kind of front and center once again in this city.
Yeah, we, you know, 20 years ago was the last time we renewed season tickets at this level. So you literally go back to the Kevin Garnett era of 2003, 2004, number two in the league in new season ticket sales. So things are really trending in a great spot for us.
Yeah, that's incredible for this franchise. I mean, such great merchandise too. As you can see, I'm sporting this. I think blue is my color. Also, there is such great concessions in the arena here at Target Center. You don't just come to a game anymore, you get a hot dog and some chips, although you can, which are my favorite. You guys got some gourmet stuff down here.
Yeah, really under the direction of Chef David Fema, who we brought in about five or six seasons ago, and really to curate a really special chef-driven, you know, menu throughout the arena. So no matter where your seats are, we want to make sure it's a really great food and beverage experience. We've got new options, El Burrito Mercado. We've got Wicked Foods, which is the first plant-based concession stand in the country. Something we're just really excited to continue, you know, stepping up our food and beverage offerings.
I didn't tell Ryan, but later we're going to have a three-point shooting contest. He might beat me on that, but I think I can take you down low. You know, I got the big sky hook going. So, hey, it's going to be a great season. It all kicks off tonight just after 7 o'clock tip-off. Oklahoma City Thunder in town. This place is going to be full and loud with the Timberwolves Rally Glow Stick. Wouldn't you guys like one of these? Come
that
on.
That looks pretty cool. Yeah. Tip-off tonight, Chris. We still got to see his three-point shot.
I know, Chris. Yeah. We want to see you make a three-pointer.
At some point today. Keep practicing. We'll check back in a bit.
Yeah, hopefully it doesn't break. It's ice cold outside. Right.
It is cold outside, but you have some decent news. I mean, it's the last day for folks waking up in Minnesota. If you have a kiddo at the bus stop, this is the last day this week, and then they're on MEA break.
And then after that, we'll start warming up, too. So, yeah, cold temperatures. Cold start this morning, kind of like Chris's jumper to kind of kick off, right? A warmer finish. I'm teasing. Later this afternoon, we'll see high temps climb to right around upper 40s, close to 50 degrees. All right, so 24 right now. If you're getting ready to step out, maybe you got to take the pup out. 18 is the feel like on the skin. Feel like temps probably won't go down much further than what they're at right now. So right around the upper teens for the wind chills and winds west-northwest at just 5 miles per hour. So here are the feel like temps for the remainder of the morning. Upper teens, low 20s. By mid-late morning, we'll see wind chills fall to the upper 30s and 40s, even though air temps make it to right around 47 for the afternoon. Here's your next 12 hours. Period of clouds early this afternoon. We'll still see some sun-cloud mix at least to start, and then we'll clear up nicely for dinner time. Temps tonight fall to the upper 30s, mid-30s by this time come tomorrow morning, which is going to feel a whole lot better on the skin. 47 this afternoon, 56 tomorrow afternoon. Tomorrow's seasonal. Friday morning, a low of 45. That's not bad at all. We'll see temps climb to right around 64. Coming up in my 7-day, I'm talking about a warming trend, of course, and some rain chances. Stick around for that.
All right, guys, we've been talking about basketball all morning. We got to talk football. We have a monster matchup heading into the MEA weekend at 6:37. Randy Shaver's got a full preview of tonight's highly anticipated game between Elk River and St. Francis.
I think I'm going to go re-up on some coffee.
Oh,
I need some.
Get after it.